Good morning students, today's class I am going to explain the practice question how you want to write the code. So the remaining question you have to practice it. The first question, write a Python program that accepts radius of circle and prints its area. So you have to get the value of the radius from the user and you have to calculate the area. What is the formula for calculating the area? Phi r square. So you have to get the input from the user. So radius equal to, when you are creating the variable, that must be related to the program, then only you can understand clearly. So radius equal to float of input into the radius. So we are getting the value from the user. What is the value the user has given? 5. Radius value 5. Area is equal to by value what? 3.14 into by radius into radius by r square. So what is the value of radius now? 5. So 3.14 into 5 into 5. So it will calculate and store it in the result as a variable area. The next, print area of the circle is format of area and the square units. So the area of the circle is in the string format, it will print as it is. And format area, what is the area? The result is 78.500. It will display as a what? Square units. This is the way you have to write the program. Okay. The next code, write a program to take year as an input and check if it is a leap year or not. So you have to get the input as a year from user. So year is an integer data type. Yes. So year equal to int input, enter the year to be checked. You are getting the input of year from the user, the first line. The second line, you have to check it whether the user given year is leap year or not. How you will check? You have to form the logic. So that year modulus 4 is equal to 0. So the year is, remainder is 00 and year modulus 100 not equal to 0 or year modulus 400 equal to 0. That means if the condition it satisfies, it will print the year is an leap year. If not, it will print the year is an not leap year. We'll check the first input, enter the year to be checked. So we are getting the input as a 2014. So you have to check it. Year, what is the value of year? 2014. Modulus, that means modulus means remainder value only you will get. What is the remainder value here? 5 4s are 20, 3 4s are 12, remaining 2. The remainder value 2. So the remainder value, it is equal to 0? No, the condition is false. The next, it will check that next condition. What is the next condition? Year 2014 divided by 100. Here also you will get the remainder 4, that is not equal to 0. This condition is true. Or (2014)/400=0. Have to check the condition. If any one condition is satisfied, it will display the year is an leap year, or else it will display the year is an not leap year. So the condition is not satisfied here, so the control will move to the else part and it will display the messages the year is not an leap year. Okay, the next statement, enter the year to be checked. What is the year we have given? 2000. So what is the value of year now? 2000. So 2000 divided by 4, the remainder modulus operator always return a remainder value. So what is the remainder value here? 0. That is equal to 0. And here also the condition will true. So it will move to the inner loop of the if statement. What is the statement it will display? The year is an leap year. So the if statement, it will check the conditions. If the condition is satisfied, it will display the inner loop of the if statement. If the condition is does not satisfy, the control will move to the else part. The next statement, write a Python script to print the following pattern. So you have to print the pattern like this. Okay, A, B, B, C, C, D, 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 next letter E. So what you can understand from this, the first letter A have to print one time, the second letter have to print two time, the third letter have to print three time, the fourth letter have to print four time, the fifth one is five time. Now we'll see the program of this code. So you have to define the function def alphabet using the keyword def alphabet of n. The n value you have to pass it in the driver code, that means alphabet n value is 5. N value it is what? 5. We are passing the n argument, the value is what? 5 in the driver code. Okay, the next line. What is the next line? Num equal to 65. Why they are assigning num is equal to 65? Because the system know the ASCII code. What is the ASCII code of the value A? Capital letter A, it will start from 65. What does mean by ASCII code? The system cannot understand the alphabets. So they have some unique code to understand the, identify the alphabets. So the capital letter A start from the value 65. Okay, that's why we are assigning the value num is equal to 65. The next, we have used two loops here. Why? Because we need to print the patterns for I in range of 0, n. What is the n value here? 5. That means what is the value, what is the range it will take? 0 to 4. Yes, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, inner loop of the J loop for J in range 0 of I plus 1. So the I value, first what is the range it will take? 0. So 0, 0 plus 1. I plus 1 means what? 0 plus 1, 2. What is the now? Sorry, 0 plus 1, 1. What is the range of J now? First time 0, 0, 1. So what is the range it will take? 0. So CH equal to character of num. CH equal to character of num. Here, CHR it is a function. Num, what is the value? 65. So the character function, it will convert that ASCII code to the character. It will return as a character. So 65, what is the character it will return? A. And it is stored in a variable CH. And it is stored in a variable CH. Now print the CH value. CH value what? A. It will print the CH value. And it will give the space. The next. Next time what? It will increment the num. What is the num value? Num 65. 65 plus 1. What is the value? 1. 65 plus 1, 66. The next slash, or it is a carriage return. And then the control will move to the J loop again. The next I state my, what is the next value it will take? What is the next I value here? It is the range is what? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here first we have 0, the next one is 0 plus 1, 1, next one is 1, 1 plus 1, 2, next I value what? 2, 2 plus 1, 3, the next I value, 0, 2, here 0, 3, here 0, I, 4 plus 1, 5, yes, 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 1, 4. Okay, next one is, up to this, it will take the range. So the next time, it will print the statement 0, 2. What is the loop? 0, 2. So first 0, 2, CH equal to character now. What is the value of num here now? 66, because we have incremented the value here now. So what is the 66 value? Alphabet B letter. So it will print the letter first. The next, end space, again one more time, 0, 1. So it will print one more time. Okay, the next it will increment the num loop, 67. So like this, the control will iterate the for loop. So the for loop will iterate the range of value what they have given in the range up to 0 to 4. It will print the statement. It will print the statement. Okay. So the next 0i plus 1. The next one is what? 0 comma i plus 1, 4, 4 plus 1, 5. Up to the range it will take. Okay. Can you understand this? Okay, ma'am. The next program. Write a program to input a line of text and prints out the count of vowels in it. So you have to get the line of text from the user. Line of text means it is a what data type? It is a string. It is a what data type? It is a string. String equal to input enter the string. The next vowels equal to 0. For I in string, for I in string, I is a control variable. I in string for loop means it will take a single string one time. So you have, it will check the next statement, if statement, if I equal to equal to small a or I equal to equal to small e. What are the vowels? A, E, I, O, U. So small letter also there, capital letters also there. So we have to check it thoroughly, that small letter and the capital letters also. So that or I equal to equal to caps lock A, I equal to equal to caps letter E. It will check it. If the control is satisfies, any one is correct, it will increment the value. Vowels what we have assigned? 0. 0 plus 1, 1. It will store it in the value 1. The next number of vowels are, it will print the statement. So listen, enter the string. What we have given? Welcome. What is our string? Welcome. So it will take the first character. What is the first character here? What is the first letter, ma? W. So it will take the first letter. I value what? W. Is equal to equal to A? No. W is equal to equal to E? No. So it does not match any value. So the control will take, move to the for loop again. It will take the next letter, E. So small I equal to equal to E. So what is the value? Vowels equal to 0 plus 1, 1. Now vowels value what? 1. Okay, the next character L. L also does not match. So it will take C value. C value also does not match. O. It will take O value. It will match and it will increment the value already in the variable vowel once. So 1 plus 1, 2. Okay, the next M also does not match. E will match. I equal to equal to small letter E. The condition is true. So it will increment the value. So 3 plus 1. Vowels already 2. 2 plus 1, 3. What is the value? 3. Now it will return the number of vowels that is present in the text. Okay. See, listen, ma. You have to study thoroughly string chapter and list and tuples functions. What are the topics you have to study? How to create the strings and tuples, accessing the strings and tuples, list, and what are the string manipulations, tuple manipulations and list manipulations, and the functions of the strings and tuples and list. You have to study thoroughly. Based on this only, the next year will continue. Okay. Thank you, ma. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Thank you, students.